Okay, so you've got the key over here, and this is trying to find the answers to problems that you've been encountering recently. You are dealing with a lot of people at the moment. So you've got the garden over here, or the park, and this is having appointments or, dealing with large groups of people, communicating your ideas to a lot of people. So you might be going through to some kind of seminar, or you could be going to some kind of event that involves a lot of people. And it looks like, in this event, you might find some answers to some questions that you've been asking. There's some solutions to your problems within this event or this meeting that you're going through. And then you've got the lilies over here, which is dealing with family issues. This could be people that are older than you in your family, and you're having some kind of dealings or something happening with them. It might be some kind of problems that you're dealing with as far as that goes. Some kind of family issues that you're dealing with. So in the past, you've got the fame card over here, the moon, and this is about, getting recognition for whatever you've been doing, finding, a lot of answers using your intuition. This is about, it's really a good omen card. So you've had something coming in, maybe some kind of revelation coming in. Maybe you've had a dream or some kind of insight that came into you in the past. And then you've got the star card over here, and this is a card about success. So both of them, getting recognition and getting a lot of success with these cards. And this has happened in the past. So going into the future, you've got the clove over here, and this is talking about some good luck coming in for you. Maybe a new job, maybe some money coming in, but some kind of luck comes in, and it's very, very sudden when it comes in. And if you're dealing with any problems, if you're dealing with these family issues that you have over here with this Lilies card, it looks like it will die off. You've got the Flames card over here, which shows that any kind of problems that you have will sort themselves out. You just have to have a little bit of patience. It will sort itself out, you come out of it quite victorious. It's all burning itself out over here. You can see with the flames. So those are the energies for that week. So I'm using Barbara Walker's tarot for the main read. I have shuffled this deck. So at the bottom, you've got the Pope over here, and this is maybe you've been getting some kind of advice, seeking some kind of expert advice recently, or looking for answers. Maybe you've been going on the internet and doing some research as well. So the Pope is ruled by Taurus. It could be involving your money. It could be financial advice that you're seeking, or seeking things about money, or even health. Because that this card also rules health or institutions. This is actually getting that advice from people, from experts. So that could well be the case. Or going and asking for advice, really. So what's happening with you? You've got the Moon card over here, and it's crossed by the Two of Cups. So there is some kind of relationship that you're dealing with. It's got the romance title on it, it's got Venus in Cancer over here, so showing that you are dealing with some kind of problems or some kind of issues or some kind of relationship matters of the heart, should I say. So this could be while your relationship, and you're feeling a bit depressed about it because you've got the Moon card over here, and this card is crossing the Moon card. So something about that relationship that you're in is making you very, very upset, or it's giving you a bit of pause for thought, if you like. You have some you've been thinking very deeply about it. There might be some problems or some issues that you are dealing with at the moment. And it's depressing you. There's no clarity because the moon doesn't bring clarity. It brings a lot of fears, and you have expectations that are not very, very realistic. So you're focusing a lot on that relationship that you're having, and you're thinking very deeply about it as well. It could be giving you nightmares and keeping you up at night as well. So you're pretty upset about it, maybe a bit depressed about it. So in the past year, you've got the accomplishment card, which is the Nine of Pentacles, showing that you've been working very, very hard. You've been very, very focused on your job, and you have been putting a lot of effort and energy into this particular thing. You really enjoy it quite a bit, and you want it to produce a lot of rewards, because you know, and you're very Virgo is a card of being very focused, and you know, a lot of research and you know, paying attention to the small details of it, being very meticulous within your work. So you've been working pretty hard at it, and you can see, you know, there's blossoms on this tree over here. So things are you know, growing, and you're waiting for to have some rewards from it. Now, the Nine of Pentacles is also about financial independence, and maybe, you know, you're reaching that point where you're able to afford things and really enjoy whatever it is you're earning. But this is also kind of feeling a bit lonely as well. So, you know, you've been putting all your effort and energy into this job, and maybe this has been affecting your love life as well. And this is maybe why you've got this this moon card, and it's got the Two of Cups crossing it. So maybe you're yearning for a relationship because you've been spending so much of time focused on accomplishing your goals. You haven't had time for romance or you know, getting out there and meeting somebody. Now you've got the Emperor card over here, so this is taking control and being in charge, and you know, sorting things out, being very, very organized in whatever you've been doing. So maybe you've even taken on some kind of leadership role in the work you're doing. The Emperor card could also signify dealing with any kind of legal circumstance. So there might be some kind of judgment or some kind of legal situation that you're dealing with as well. And that's been going on for the last 3 months. So what's in your mind? You've got the Five of Swords, and this is feeling very defeated. This is what you're feeling. You're feeling maybe isolated, neglected. You can see you know, left out of the situation, because this person's right on the top of the tree over there, and everybody's having fun at the bottom of here. So maybe you feel that, you know, you are being excluded from a group, excluded from company, or feeling very isolated, left out of the crowd, left out by people, and that is, you know, that's upsetting you. So what's in your mind? You've got the Three of Swords over here. So you're pretty depressed about something at this particular moment. You know, it could well be this relationship. There might have been problems with the relationship. Maybe this is the reason why there's the Five of Swords. The Five of Swords is like, you know, about somebody taking advantage of you. So there's something, maybe there was an argument that happened within that relationship that has caused you to feel, you know, defeated, feel as though, you know, maybe there was a breakup within that relationship, because you've got the Three of Swords, and that is crying over the breakup. And you know, this is talking about severing or detaching. So maybe you know, there has been a breakdown of communication between you and the person that you were involved in. With Saturn over here, Saturn usually cuts things off, and you know, you've been, and this is about cutting, you know, communication. Libra is about trying to find that balance, and you're feeling a bit out of balance at this moment. And you know, it's a card of sorrow, so crying over this loss of communication or loss of this relationship that you're going through. So what's happening with you? You've got the Five of Wands over here, which is Saturn in Leo, and you know, this is talking about having no confidence or feeling as though you know, it's, this card says impasse, which means that whatever problems you and this person that you're dealing with in this relationship, you'll have reached a point where, you know, you can't seem to move forward at all, and you are feeling very victimized. You can see this person has been tortured by the people around him. So if you reached a point where there's been lots of arguments, and you'll reached a point where you can't seem to reconcile your differences, and you're dealing with, you know, this could be even about physical violence, because the Wands card is about physical things. So, you know, there's been a lot of arguments and fights and violence maybe within this relationship, and you know, it's been very distressing, and been very hard. Saturn is a planet that gives you makes everything difficult, really. And since it's in Leo, it's affecting your self-confidence as well. So this person might be saying things or doing things that is making you feel very depressed, or is, you know, affecting how you see yourself, and how you know, it affects your ego rather. So this person is making you feel really insignificant, and this is what they're saying or the things that they're doing. And it also seems as though, everybody's ganging up against you as well. That's how you're feeling at this particular moment. It looks like there's some kind of choice that you have to make as well. You've got these two bowls and they've got blood in them. So there's some kind of important decision you have to make at this particular point. So you have to decide whether or not you're going to sit there and take all the abuse that you've been going through, or you're going to leave. And you're at that particular point where whatever that has happened to you has brought you down to your knees, and you are feeling very victimized, or you're feeling very isolated because nobody seems to be standing up for you at this particular moment. Everybody seems to be almost against you here. And that's how you're feeling and within this relationship. Now you've got the devil card over here. So this person that you're involved in seems to be very controlling. You've got them being people who humiliate you, take advantage of you, use you to do things, and keep you very restricted. Maybe this person is somebody who, watches your every move, watches what you're doing all the time, and has tabs on you, keeps tabs on you all the time. So you're dealing with that kind of person. And it could be a Capricorn person that you're dealing with, because the devil is a sign ruled by Capricorn. So, or it could, yeah, it could be other earth signs, but it's basically, the Capricorn energy is coming through, a very restrictive, limiting kind of energy coming through. And you've got the Seven of Swords over here. So you're trying to put up a fight. You're very defensive with the Seven of Swords here, trying to walk away from a situation that is not serving you. Maybe you feel as though this person has even lied and cheated. With the Seven of Swords, it's always about deception. So, dealing with this person, they say one thing and they do something else. So, and you're feeling very, very, you can see this woman sitting with her hands crossed across her chest. So feeling very defensive, trying to put up a fight against this particular person. And going to the future, you've got the World card, the Prince of Pentacles, and the Papess. So the World cards is showing that whatever is going on over here, the cycle is about to end. So this relationship that you're going through has reached its natural end. You've got the Three of Swords showing about a breakup or detachment from that particular situation. And you've got the Five of Swords on your mind. So, this person has been very nasty to you and has done some really nasty things. You can see this man is crucified over here, and there's lots of swords in this tree. This tree is bare. So whatever was going on in that relationship was not productive, and it was detrimental to your health. And nobody is helping you out in this particular situation. They're getting on with their lives. These women are weaving thread here, or they're making cotton, according to the story from the card. And they've all let you up to dry. It's your and you're in a position, in a place where you feel very, very unsatisfied, unproductive. You feel that there's quite a lack. That relationship was lacking in something, but there was also a lot of harsh things that were said, or a lot of nastiness that was said. Now the World card is saying that this is the end of that cycle. And this is also a card ruled by Saturn, so that means that cycle is now finished and done with, and it is time for you to detach from it. It is time for you to move on. If it was a karmic situation, this particular relationship is now karmically ending, because this is a major arcana card, and it's showing that whatever you've been dealing with has now reached its natural conclusion. And then you've got the Prince of Pentacles over here. So this is now you're going to have to, focus on your work. So this is focusing on your work and trying to manifest, material abundance. And the Prince of Pentacles is like, the Knight of Pentacles. So this is working hard and moving away from that situation. So whatever happened within that relationship, you're going to have to refocus and focus your energies on your work, on studying, on acquiring knowledge. And even with a Hierophant card, it's a card ruled by Taurus, and it's also about learning and learning lessons that have happened. So this is about learning, or even changing whatever your values used to be into something different. It's letting go of the past, not being stuck in the old ideals that you had, but moving forward, and moving forward because you acquire new knowledge. And this Prince of Pentacles is talking about learning something new. Whatever happened in this relationship was a learning experience for you. Now you have to change your focus, take all these things that you learned, leave that past behind and move forward. And then you've got the Papists over here. This is also about education and learning. So there might be a new course and study that is coming in. This is also about keeping all your secrets to yourself and not speaking, divulging all your inner secrets or your whatever insights you've had. Keep them and learn from them. And this is about using your intuition. So Pisces has got very, very strong intuition, and it's a very spiritual sign. So this is about acquiring spiritual knowledge as well. So it looks like there might be some studying or learning coming in for you here. And this is also refocusing on your work. So whatever it is, it has reached its final conclusion, its natural end. It looks like with the Three of Swords, the communication is now broken down between the two of you. You are feeling lonely, isolated, in the dark about a lot of things. There might have been other people that were involved in it, but it is time to let this go and regain your balance. And it seems like, you know, a lot of people were against you in the circumstance, but it seems to be have been a very aggressive situation to be in. And you've reached an impasse with this person. There doesn't seem to be any way forward with this particular person. They seem to be very, very dominating with this Devil card over here, taking control over you, keeping you in the dark, keeping you under subjugation. And you know, you are trying to fight back with this opposition card and Seven of Swords, but there is a lot of deception as well going on over there, because the Seven of Swords is talking about deception. So it is, and you know, the Moon card as well, talking about lies and deceit and deception as well. There's blood around the Moon over here. So whatever they've got to say has hit you very, very deeply. And you are very miserable about the whole circumstance. So it's all to do with this relationship that you're going through. You need to get some advice with this Pope card. It's about getting some spiritual advice as well. So I'm just going to draw some cards from the Animal Tarot. So the first card is Release, which says it's time to release the past and move to something new. This ending is the first step on the way to future happiness. So it's important with this card. This is the Death card usually in the tarot, and it's talking about releasing that situation and moving forward. You can see this peacock's got beautiful feathers, and there's a butterfly over here. So something beautiful is coming in for you, and this is a transformation. The rose has fallen. The rose has got two things. It's got thorns in it, even though it's so beautiful. So even though you thought that relationship was wonderful, it's something that wasn't. It caused a lot of pain and hurt. So it is time to let it go and move forward. And you've got the Ten of Winter. This is another ending of a cycle, because tens are about endings. And the end of a career path, project, or relationship brings feelings of mixed joy and sadness, relief, and disappointment. Put aside your fears about these changes and trust that there is a brighter future. So this is definitely the end of a relationship, and you're going to have to let go of it and move on. Something better is coming in for you. Then you've got the Three of Winter over here. Sadness is part of life, but you don't have to endure it alone. You may need a little time to heal, but once you work your way through your emotions, you will be stronger than before. So the Three of Winter is, almost like the Three of Swords over here. You're working through this problem. You need to let go of it. There's a new cycle of the Moon coming, and there are people around you. You can see these birds together that will give you that support that you need. So there's somebody that you can speak to about it. And you need to let go of it and move on, because it is detrimental to your health. It will be detrimental to your psyche as well. So you need to let go of this old relationship. It's come to its natural conclusion. Refocus on your work. And you know, if you have to go back and learn something new, like do a new course or take on a new hobby, but learn something new, that will help you shift that focus of depression onto something more positive. So it will convert that negative energy into positive energy. So I hope that this reading has resonated with you. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, leave me some comments if it has. Thank you so much for watching. Take care now. Goodbye.